This is a good time, I think, to talk about a very important event
that you were involved in, and that is the construction of the Tejano Monument on the Capitol grounds, because I think that exemplifies exactly what you're talking about with regards to the TSHA. We as Tejano historians, particularly, especially you, join with the historians from outside the academy to organize this effort to build a monument commemorating Tejano history. And I think that is an important point in our recent history, because that is what encouraged me and you to go further and approach TSHA with
the idea of a handbook of Tejano history. But
real briefly, do you want to say anything about the Handbook of Texas? I know you're going to talk about it later in greater detail.
The Tejano Monument.
The Tejano Monument, yes.
Yeah, the Tejano Monument is one of the largest monuments on the Texas State Capitol grounds. And it's probably one of the largest monuments on any state capitol ground in the United States. It is a monument that has 10 statues on it. And it was conceived one evening when I was in Edinburgh visiting with Dr. Cayetano Barrera, a distinguished physician of South Texas, Richard Sanchez, who is now vice chancellor at a university in South Texas, and Homero Vera, a local South Texas historian, and myself. There were four of us visiting one night, and we were all remarking on the fact that on the entire Capitol grounds, in the Capitol, in all the state buildings, there was not one photograph, not one picture, not one plaque, not one statue. There was nothing to commemorate the fact that Mexican Americans had ever existed in the state of Texas. And we just agreed, and we had basically a pact among us four. We are going to put something on the state capitol grounds. We said, so let's put a statue up. And so we did, in fact, incorporate as Tejano Statue, Inc., later Tejano Monument, Inc. And then as we went along, we had to incorporate. We had to have a bill passed through the legislature. And as we started working with the legislature to get approval to put up a statue, we brought in another member, Renato Ramirez, a banker from South Texas, who played a key role in helping us marshal the funds, bring in funding. And then eventually we brought in an architect. He was supposed to help us with the architecture, but he became one of the movers that helped us design, along with the sculptor, the Tejano Monument and the base of the Tejano Monument. So it took us 12 years to raise about $2.6 million. And we finally were able to erect the Tejano Monument. And to segue into another topic that you and I want to talk about, we had some funds left over. And so you and I personally had already talked about a curriculum program that you had already founded, and you were looking for funding for it. When on the Tejano Monument Board of Directors, I told the other directors, I know of a project that I think we ought to use these extra funds for. So I made a motion that we fund your curriculum project, Tejano History Curriculum Project, which initially was called the Tejano Monument Curriculum Project or something, wasn't it?
Something like that.
Something like that. And so with that funding, then, you were able to get your curriculum program,
which continues to this date. It's been now about 5 years. At this point, we've partnered with the Austin School District and are sponsoring a Saturday morning class for fourth and fifth graders on Tejano history. And the group is Nuestro Grupo, a community organization. But that is basically the history, or the beginning of the history of the Handbook of Tejano History. It's about then that we began to talk about then speaking to another audience, or using another means to speak to the larger audience, and that was the Handbook of Texas.
I was talking earlier about the Tejano Monument, and I mentioned that that there were several of us that came together. Actually, there were about 30 people in a broader committee that we had that the Board of Directors worked with. We brought in people from different parts of the state. And The statue turned into a monument of 10 statues. They were sculpted by Armando Hinojosa of Laredo. I'm going to tell a little bit about the monument. Physically, it's at the very gate of the Texas State Capitol. It has one statue of a Spaniard, and the Spaniard is looking off onto the horizon. He's holding a land grant in his hand. He's not wearing a helmet. He doesn't have a sword. He has a land grant, because we wanted to say the Spaniard brought order, government. And then another statue is an equestrian of a Tejano vaquero on horseback. Very significantly, the horse is a mesteño. He's a Mustang, a uniquely Texas Mustang. And the vaquero, very distinctively, has a little bit of facial hair to indicate that he was part European, but also part Indian, part Native American. He's a mestizo, mixed blood, Tejano. Then we have another group on the monument of a husband and wife holding a baby, because the family is what founded Texas. San Antonio was founded with families the first day it was founded. They didn't come as explorers and then bring families later, 100 years later. The families were in the founding expedition in every one of the town or communities. So the family was critical. We wanted to show that. We wanted to show that there were children. There are children and there are small animals. There are two longhorns, because we wanted Texans to know these are the people that brought the longhorns. Longhorns did not grow on trees. They were bred, and longhorns don't grow anywhere else in the world, but right here in South Texas. And then longhorns and those horses and those animals are the ones that created, through these Tejanos, the North American ranching industry. We wanted people to know that. We also have five bronze plaques that tell textually, in text, in front of the monument, the story of the Tejano monument, the Tejano culture and history. So, once again, it was our way of saying, we're going to tell our story, but it's going to be a positive, constructive story of how we expanded Texas history. And the people who unveiled the monument were the governor of Texas, the lieutenant governor of Texas, the founding families, the De Leon family, the Esparza, the Seguin, those founding families who had brought Tejano culture. Because we wanted the monument to show it's part of Texas history. It's part of the state capital. This is not just a protest of a bunch of outsiders.
And this is obviously a taste of the kinds of articles that are appearing now on Tejanos and on the Handbook of Texas. But there's something that your article doesn't say that came up during the unveiling of the monument that I'd like for you to talk about. You all invited, the board invited the descendants of the Leon family, the Seguin family, and other important families of that early period to come and help in the unveiling. And each one of the statues had a material over it. And then you asked them to come forward, including some children from our curriculum project, to unveil different statues.
But you said something that I thought was very important and historical.
You said, "We are still here." And then you asked them to pull the veil off the statues.
We were taught, the board of directors was talking about the unveiling, and one of our important members, board members, Juanita, my wife, Juanita Tijerina, who had been a publisher here in Austin and knew politics and the media pretty well, said, "No, the governor's not going to unveil it. The Tejano families, the original Tejano families, the ones who brought the longhorns, the ones who brought the ranches, the ones who established the land grants." And so we all looked around at each other and we said, "I guess that's what it's going to be." And mm-hmm. So that's right. When the longhorns were unveiled, the two longhorns, we let the Bailly family, mm-hmm. one of the original ranching families of Texas, do that. When the family group, the husband and wife, rancher and the child, of statues were unveiled. We let the De Leon family and on, the different big original Tejano families. And so that's why at the end of my address at the inaugural, I pointed out these were the first families of Texas. And that's what Tejano means. Tejano means Texan. These are the original Tejanos, the original Texans, and they're still here. And they're not part of history. In fact, I've always said, when I teach Texas history to a lot of people, it's genealogy.